Hello everyone and welcome back to First Umma PW. First of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming back to listen in, but I'd like to wish you all a very happy new year. We've entered a new year with a hope that life will be better soon. Continuing with our theme, Side by Side, this month I have asked a friend of mine to share some thoughts with us about people drawing side by side. I would like to introduce you to Priscilla Reid, who alongside her husband Paul has travelled the world to speak at churches and conferences. I don't think we've ever had a worldwide speaker before. But before I hand over to Priscilla to talk to us, I want to read some verses from the Bible, and I'm going to read from Ruth chapter 1, verses 1 to 18. And Ruth chapter 1. In the days when the judges ruled, there was a famine in the land. So a man from Bethlehem in Judah, together with his wife and two sons, went to live for a while in the country of Moab. The man's name was Elimelech, his wife's name was Naomi, and the name of his two sons were Mahlon and Chilion. They were Ephrathites from Bethlehem in Judea, and they went to Moab and lived there. Now Elimelech, Naomi's husband, died, and she was left with her two sons. They married Moabite women, one named Orpah and the other Ruth. After they had lived there about 10 years, both her sons died, and Naomi was left without her two sons and her husband. When Naomi heard in Moab that the Lord had come to the aid of his people by providing food for them, she and her daughters-in-law prepared to return home from there. With her two daughters-in-law, she left the place where she had been living and set out on the road that would take them back to the land of Judah. Then Naomi said to her two daughters-in-law, "Go back, each of you, to your mother's home. May the Lord show you kindness as you have shown kindness to your dead husbands and to me. May the Lord grant that each of you will find rest in the home of another husband." Then she kissed them goodbye, and they wept aloud and said to her, "We will go back with you to your people." But Naomi said, "Return home, my daughters. Why would you come with me? Am I going to have any more sons who could become your husbands? Return home, my daughters. I am too old to have another husband. Even if I thought there was still hope for me, even if I had a husband tonight and then give birth to sons, would you wait until they grow up? Would you remain unmarried for them? No, my daughters, it is more bitter for me than for you, because the Lord's hand has turned against me." At this they wept aloud again. Then Orpah kissed her mother-in-law goodbye, but Ruth clung to her. "Look," said Naomi, "your sister-in-law is going back to her people and her gods. Go back with her." But Ruth replied, "Don't urge me to leave you or to turn back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if even death separates you from me." When Naomi realized that Ruth was determined to go with her, she stopped urging her. Amen.
Hello, ladies of First Umma. It is a real privilege for me to get to share in this series that you're looking at women working together, which is a great passion of mine, and so it's a delight to talk to you about that today. Many of you won't know me. Margaret asked me to join in with this study that you're doing, and Margaret and I go a long way back, too long to remember. She and I used to work together in the library, and then her brother and I were at university together, and we're great friends together. So it's a privilege for me to join in today. For those of you who don't know me, I'm married to Paul. We have 4 grown-up daughters, and we have 9 grandchildren, 8 girls and 1 boy. So you can see that women working together is really important to me. And as I thought about this subject, the story from the Bible that came to my mind was the story of Ruth and Naomi, because I think it exemplifies the whole idea of women working together, but not just working together, having a relationship together, and how that they were able to achieve so much more together than they could ever have achieved on their own, which of course is the theme of the New Testament as well, because in the New Testament it was never envisaged that we would be just Christians on our own, trying to make it on our own, just heading out into the sunset, me and Jesus. But the New Testament is full of one another instructions, how we're to encourage one another, pray for one another, support one another, and that we are to work together as well. And so as I read this story again, and I would really recommend just sit down and read it at one sitting, because it is a wonderful book, and it's a short book, and you will be able to see so much in it about the benefits when women come together to work together. And it's a lovely story too, because it's about a friendship and a relationship across the generations, which is another thing that we can do in church. You know, the generations aren't separate from each other, but as older women, we can have great relationships with younger women and vice versa, and we can bring something to that relationship. Naomi was the older woman. She had gone with her husband Elimelech to Moab whenever there was famine in the land of Israel. She'd gone there with her two sons. They had met two Moabite girls, Orpah and Ruth. And Orpah? I don't think it was Orpah. It was Orpah. That was for a later day. And so Ruth had married one of Naomi's sons, but the family had a really tragic time. The father died, the two boys died. So now here was Naomi, away from her homeland, grieving over the loss of her family. Ruth, a young widow, which in that culture and in that time was a huge burden to bear. And these two women are brought together in the story. And I just want to, in our time together, look at Naomi first and what she brought into her relationship with Ruth, and then to look at Ruth and what she brought into her relationship with Naomi, and how those two things working together not only impacted their lives and blessed their lives, but also had a much wider impact. And so, as I said, when we meet Naomi, she is not in a good place, and she has decided that she wants to return to her homeland. And so she prepares to say goodbye to her daughter-in-laws, which again in that culture was a brave thing to do, because they were the ones that would have been expected to look after her. But she had their best interests at heart. And she said, look, girls, you can't come with me, because, you know, there's no way I'm going to be able to bear any more children to become husbands for you. You need to go back to your own people, your own gods. And she really, even though she was in a really heartbroken place herself, she was really looking out for them. And of course, we know the story, how that Ruth absolutely refused to leave her. Those wonderful words that are, you know, often quoted in Ruth chapter 1. Don't urge me to leave you or turn back from you. Where you go, I will go. And where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if even death separates you and me. And when Naomi realized that Ruth was determined to go with her, she stopped urging her. You know, I think this relationship, the first thing that's really important to note is that Naomi actually introduced Ruth to the living God. Naomi knew God. Her name means pleasant, and I don't think that was just a meaning of the name. I think Naomi was a pleasant woman. We meet her when she was grieving and suffering, but I believe that Ruth was attracted to her and attracted to her faith. And I think it was how Naomi lived that impacted Ruth's life. She made following God attractive to Ruth. And in a sense, Ruth's determination to cling to her was like, I want what you have, Naomi. I want to follow this God as well. And I believe that Ruth really loved her mother-in-law, and that Naomi drew Ruth in to get to know the true God. And you know, that is a wonderful privilege that we have as women working together. I went to a conference several years ago in Turkey, and it was a women's conference. And when I went into the room, there were mostly older women there, my age and older. But there was about a quarter of the women were, I would say, probably 25 and under. And it just seemed a strange mix because there weren't many women in their 40s and 50s. And then as the conference went on, I realised that it was the older women who had introduced the younger women to Jesus and now were discipling them. So that's what Naomi did for Ruth. And I think she inspired Ruth to live for God. You know, that Ruth was prepared to leave her family and her culture and her country to go with Naomi. And I think we need, as women working together, we need relationships in our lives that inspire us to live for God. And Naomi taught her the things of God. She had grown, Ruth had grown in her understanding of who this God is. Actually, when she meets Boaz, Boaz talks about the God under whose wings she had come to take refuge. So she had grown in a relationship with God, and I think Naomi taught her about that and encouraged her in the things of God. And then, you know, she shared her life with her. This was a very painful time in Naomi's life, but obviously they had shared life together before this. And Naomi was very honest and very vulnerable with Ruth, saying to her just how she felt. Don't call me Naomi because my life has become bitter. And you know, I honestly think probably at this point Naomi was actually depressed as she was setting off home with all of her hopes dashed. But she shared her life with Ruth, not just the good times but the bad times as well. It wasn't just a working relationship, and I think that's important for what we're thinking about, that it's not just that we're working together but that we have real, honest, vulnerable relationships with each other as well, because that's what makes it work. And I think Naomi modeled out to Ruth humility. I mean, she was going back home, she was going to have to admit that they had failed. And she modeled something out to Ruth, and she was very honest. She had to, return, and almost there was this stigma attached to her having to admit failure. She said, "I went away full, but the Lord has brought me back empty." But Naomi, in this working relationship, released Ruth. She didn't smother her. And I think that's really important as we work together, that we release each other to be the best version of ourselves that we can be, whether we're older or younger. And that as older women, that if we have working relationships with younger women, like, we set them free to fly and to be the best that they can be, and not try to just constantly, you know, tell them how things ought to be done or how they used to be done. We can learn from their new ideas and creativity, and I think they can learn from some of the lessons that we have been taught in our lives as well. So it's important to release and not to smother. And then, you know, Naomi had accrued a lot of wisdom, and so she instructs Ruth. Ruth's going into a new culture, she doesn't know what it's going to be like, but she instructs Ruth in that new culture, and as a result of that, Ruth does find a husband. She finds Boaz, and I think she gave Ruth confidence. She affirmed her, and she, you know, her, it was almost like, you know, her hand was at Ruth's back, and she sent her out and gave Ruth the confidence. You know, that was a very brave thing for that young woman to do, to have to go and glean in a field and be the stranger and be the refugee, really. But she knew Naomi was behind her and supporting her and affirming her. And so in all of that, then Naomi enabled Ruth to find her destiny in God. And whenever Ruth and Boaz got married and they had a baby, then Naomi helped take care of this new family. And actually, you know, the community celebrated this because Naomi served the next generation. She got a new lease of life. Actually, the other women said, "Naomi has a son," and that's how it was viewed in that day. And of course, that son becomes part of the line of David. And so therefore, in the genealogy of Jesus coming to earth. So that was how big this was. As these women worked together, it wasn't just that Naomi invested something in Ruth, but actually they had an impact on God's story of redemption for the earth. And just very briefly to mention, you know, Ruth and what she brought to the relationship. She had a servant heart. She was willing to sacrifice her country and her culture to go with Naomi and support her in everything that she was doing. And she was a determined young woman. She clung to Naomi and she refused to go back. And so she was absolutely determined that what she had seen in Naomi, she was going to follow her and follow her God as well. And she developed her own relationship with God and was prepared to embrace the new. Naomi didn't cling to the past. Ruth didn't cling to the past. They both moved forward into a new future together, but I think they supported each other in that. I think Naomi, although she told Ruth to go back, she really needed Ruth's support. She needed Ruth's youthful energy. She needed the fact that Ruth was willing to go out and work and get some food and help provide for them as well. And Ruth was incredibly loyal. And I think when we're working together, we need that kind of loyalty with one another. And courageous, the courage it took for her to go with Naomi. And then, of course, Ruth was such a blessing in Naomi's life, because as she met Boaz, as they had a family together, this, you know, Naomi suddenly did have a new season in her life and a new lease of life. It's almost like that verse in Hosea that talks about God making the valley of tears a door of hope. That's exactly what Ruth did for Naomi. And so, in conclusion, here are two women who had a relationship together but who worked together. And in doing that, they found their purpose in God. They became part of God's bigger story for the redemption of all of humanity. And I don't think either of them would have made it on their own, but together they accomplished so much. And our lesson from Naomi and Ruth, I think not just in friendship and in our amongst our peers, but across the generations, are that if as women we will work together, affirm and encourage one another, we can achieve so much more together than we ever will apart.
Thanks very much to Priscilla for those words about Ruth and Naomi and the encouragement it brings to us to be helping each other side by side. We will just finish with a word of prayer, and then after that, hopefully, we will see you again in February. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for your word which makes clear how your people should relate to one another. Help us to be intentional in encouraging one another and building each other up, as you have told us to do. Forgive us for often being hesitant to do as you command. Help us to actively seek opportunities to care for others, and in doing so, demonstrate your love to them. Help each one of us to put into action what we have decided to do as a first step. May we always be ready to get alongside those you put in our path for their and our benefit and for your glory alone. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.